Well, I thought I'd drop in, pay a visit to Ambriel.
Yes?
I don't remember her sitting outside.
Have we met before? And who might you be? I see. But where are my manners? My name is Ambrielle. A pleasure to meet you.
I like these two characters in
Oh,
the background there.
that is a long story. A very long story.
It's like
Perhaps you'd like to listen to it?
And why is she staying on the bench? Really, you're gonna stand on the bench?
I think I can trust you. Only Talos knows why.
So, off in the distance there
My
is
story.
a bad cosplay
Where
of a
should I start?
dragonborn and of
I am Princess
Serana.
Ambrielle of Tamriel. I was born 500 years ago, and I cannot die.
Okay, Highlander.
Okay. Now that was the short version. Talos made me immortal when I was born, and my father, Emperor Pelagius III, lost his life. So my mother told me. That was the price to keep the balance between the forces of good and evil and prevent a direct war between the Nine and the Daedra princes. My mother, Empress Ketoriah, told me something about a prophecy regarding me, the Empire, the Thalmor, and an Elder Scroll. For many years, she traveled extensively throughout the Empire, always searching for information. But she was killed before she could solve the secret. Really? Then I think it's more than destiny that we met. I've spent enough time trying to run away. Perhaps. Sanctuaria. She is an old and wise sorceress, and she has helped me from time to time in the past. The last time I saw her was at the College of Winterhold. We should go to her immediately. I will come with you.
So Ambriel's dressed as a Thalmor because that's her disguise. She doesn't want
Okay,
anyone to
then.
recognize her as an immortal princess from Cyrodiil.
Need something? Until next time.
Oh, he's got a gray face. Still, I thought they fixed it in the last version.
Take care if you're venturing too far from town. That's a bitter wind coming off the Sea of Ghosts.
Whatever. Let's see if she makes one of them a follower.
Please, could you not stare at my back? That's not very ladylike. Yes?
Oh, I have to tell her to follow me.
I'm glad you asked. Who knows what adventures await us?
She doesn't just follow you
I
automatically.
appreciate any assistance. Together, we are less vulnerable. Nice to meet you. My name is Ambrielle. What can I do for you?
By Ysmir, this will not end
I have
well.
to make some notices.
Maybe you can help me.
I can't follow you. You already have someone with you.
I saw you do that, you know. It can't be helped.
You are right.
Anyway, it's just a weird thing that's in the mod. Half the time, you just don't even pay
Please,
attention to
take
those
this
two.
as a gift. I want you to have it. Winterhold. A cold city, but nice people. The college is a fascinating place. Oh, quite chilly, is it not?
So I raced through this
Well,
quest
then
with her.
again. This is Skyrim,
So I could have her as
so
a
I guess
follower.
chilly would be an understatement.
And I only had one bug, and that was because of the combat mods I'm using. It was the same bug I had in the last playthrough.
I think we should go to the sorceress to find out more about my past. Okay.
But for the heck of it, I went to the forums to see what bugs she has for other people, and it's just endless.
Oh, look! It's snowing. I hope we can find a warm place soon.
So many people want all the cheat codes to this mod, so they can just skip entire quests. Just seems weird to me. I mean, if she's broken in your game, I would try to find out why instead of just skipping ahead to the next quest, not knowing why she's broken in the game. But I notice when she comes in the house and we leave the house, she no longer wears the Thalmor helmet. It disappears or something.
Knock off for lunch.
I don't know what she does with the helmet. And when you give it to her, she doesn't want to wear it. She hates wearing that helmet. But you don't know that at first when she just kind of loses the helmet somewhere in the game. You're like, didn't you have a helmet when I first met you? And she's like, what? I didn't want to use her spell book. I don't trust spell books. In case they're overpowered. Usually they are. They don't align very well with all the other spell books that are already in Skyrim. They're like a cheat of some kind, you know, money cheat. I don't want that in my Skyrim. So I'll just leave the book where I found it. I already got enough mods to add all kinds of junk to my Skyrim that I haven't even used yet. She has a magical protection spell on the house, that's why it's all weird colors.
We should visit the local inn. It's a nice... Winterhold. It's now a little more than a shell of its former self, due to the great collapse.
Oh, she still has her helmet. Yeah, somewhere along the way, it wasn't very long after this, her helmet just disappears. I think if I meet her in a tavern, she won't be wearing the helmet. So that could have happened too. A more major problem I have is the elf that stands here isn't standing here. How do I get inside the college? We're supposed to meet some amazing sorceress, and I need access to the college. Hello? Where's Feralda? Dereliction of duty. She's not standing there. Probably just the two normal people that stand there waiting for me to show up so they can start to do the quest.
The college is filled with such wonders, but I wish that traveling from floor to floor was a bit more magical. Why have stairs?
It's just weird. Everyone else comes out except for Feralda.
I've seen it before back in Cyrodiil, so why not do the same here?
So maybe the immersive college of Winterhold is interfering with the immersive citizen AI overhaul. People say, oh, the two mods work together. Well, you know, whatever.
Like all the other residents around here.
Hardly anyone playtests these things. They just assume, oh, I got all those endorsements, it must be a perfect mod. Me? I never look at how many endorsements a mod gets before I download it. I assume the mod's broken every time. Because I'm always finding problems with mods. Always! I'll report a bug to a modder like 3 years after the mod's been released, and they're like, oh, really? And they go and fix it. They're amazed that I reported a bug to something they haven't really paid any attention to in 3 years. And then I'm amazed that they actually updated their mod after 3 years. I wouldn't be able to remember how something I wrote 3 years ago worked, probably. And all these chuckleheads are endorsing and saying the mod's amazing, but none of them said anything about the bug. Just weird. It's weird what people do in their Skyrims. Anyway, there's no Feralda here. I don't know where she is. I mean, I know where she is, but I'm not going into the bowels to do her intro.
I like the College of Winterhold. Magic and sorcery have always fascinated me as a little girl. Perhaps the Mages Guild will eventually reestablish someday.
I was thinking, well, maybe she'll come out briefly. Like she has to go potty or something. She has to go eat lunch. She wants to see what's in the vending machine.
The security situation in Skyrim got
out in the quad.
Civil War. Many of the guards have to fight, and it's easier for the bandits to raid the people.
But yeah, this storm sends her straight home. It sends her indoors. She refuses to stand outside when this blizzard's going on. And guess what? My Skyrim, it's always a blizzard. My Winterhold is always a blizzard. Always. If I had the clear shout, I could probably use it, you know, the clear sky shout. I don't have it. Because I think if I shout the blizzard away, then she'll immediately come outside. Stand out there to test me. Yeah, Embryo just talks and talks and talks. There's no way to shut her up either. So you just have to block her out of your mind when she's talking.
What a nice weather! I love the sunshine.
Okay, now this weather doesn't look too bad. Any of you, Feralda? You bastards.
Don't touch me.
Okay, so I have her reference ID written down somewhere. One of my many notes in my notebook. I have a journal. I have my own journal I write in. So I can keep track of what issue caused what issue to happen and which playthrough, that kind of thing. Oh, we got this guy here. I forgot. These bounty hunters follow you around the place. And when you run up to them, they run away. And I didn't know it before, but if you kill one of them, another bounty hunter takes their place and they start following you. So that's kind of cool. Because when you're first told about Ambriel, you're standing there with about, I want to say, 6 other bounty hunters. I went through all of them. I killed all the bounty hunters until there were none left.
Stupid chicken.
Because the bounty hunters will tell the bad guy where you're at, where you hang out, where you live, what taverns you go to, and then he sends out his Thalmor agents to come murder you. It's kind of brutal. I forgot that happens with the mod.
Yes? Until next time. Hey.
See, this is when her helmet disappeared. It's like, what did you do?
I would be very grateful for your help. Together, we can find it. This object would be of great help. I'm ready if you are. Hi.
And this is just the default Ambriel that I've...
Always a pleasure.
If I remember right, I think I just installed her as is. I didn't tweak any skin textures. I have no idea what body she uses. She might just use whatever female body replacer that you have.
The guards are sometimes a bit strange, talking about knees and arrows.
The armor she's wearing is just whatever armors I have in the game. So I'm guessing she'll just use whatever bodies you have installed. Anyway, so I decided to just move for all to here.
Cross the bridge at your own peril.
Yeah.
The way is dangerous and the gate will not open. You shall not gain entry.
We all have so much to fight for. But we must never forget, we have so many loved ones we could lose.
Oh,
that is
forgive
why
me.
We must win. We will
most
win.
Who arrive here do so because they have heard of the college beforehand.
Hello, my lord.
This is the College of Winterhold. A safe haven for
that's
mages
nice.
In Skyrim. A place of wisdom and arcane knowledge. Perhaps. But what is it you expect to find within? Ah, the Immortal Plane. It is said to be the source of all magic. This is a noble goal, indeed. It would seem that the college has what you seek. The question now is, what can you offer the college? Not just anyone is allowed inside. Those wishing to enter must show some degree of skill with magic.
Keep
a small test, if you will.
A dragon would be a horrible surprise.
No, I'm afraid I don't know anything of the sort.
Hello.
Excellent. The fear spell has saved the life of many an illusion mage. If you could cast it on the skill...
I was like, yes, I have the fear spell. I can do this.
I look forward to it.
She tends to give you stuff you don't have. And I thought I had the fear, but no, I have the fury. Not the fear. So, I thought, well, I'll just come back later, and when I have the fear spell, how hard can it be? It's always very hard trying to track someone down who's got that spell that you can just... And then I always forget, you can frickin' buy the spell from her if you don't have it. Yeah, she's gonna run past that thing. She won't. I don't think she's gonna stop. Yeah, she just keeps on walking. So I don't know where she goes. There's the bounty hunter who's been staying behind me the whole time, listening to what I say to people. Anyway, the dog is modded. It's a remish. So the dog is bigger than normal. Different color. Blue eyeballs that glow.
That's a pity, though. Sometimes you have to kill them in order to survive.
Just taking pictures of this place before she talks and adds subtitles to my photos. So I thought I'd kill this bounty hunter if I could hit him, if I can aim straight. Got him. I've got Voice of the Sky active for the moment, so creatures won't hurt me, but they'll still go after other creatures, such as the dog. My talking dog. We should go get the axe! You know, that's constantly what he says when I click on the dog. And Ambriel has this saber cat that's ginormous. She summons constantly. Come on, dog, what are you doing? The dog still wants to fight a polar bear.
As long as the Emperor of Tamriel lives, there is no need for me to become Empress. Perhaps the prophecy is wrong on this part.
So I was gonna go visit the Shrine of Azura. So once again, I was playing with the faces of my NPCs. I wanted to see what the
trouble ahead.
What the priestess looked like that hangs out up there. Be ignoring me and just going after the dog. That was weird. The faction system in Skyrim sucks. Sucks the big one. That music playing means that
no, you don't.
Darth Vader's in town, so... He likes to kill everything. And he summons gargoyles? I don't remember that. He summons bats and gargoyles. I didn't know it, but the guy, he's essential, so he can't be killed. So I was like, why does he have these fight scenes with this? If he can't kill him. So I thought, okay. How tough is he? Yeah, he's pretty tough.
We should go get the axe.
Yeah.
All right, then. We'll get together later.
Weird part is, I have no idea where that dog goes when you say, we'll get together later. Because the dog was not where I thought it was not where I thought it would go.
If we ever go to Solitude, we should visit the local inn.
Is someone
it's a
there?
Nice, I expected this.
Okay, let's try this again.
That was a bit too easy.
So kill that. Kill the thing.
Who knows?
Once again, the wolves won't attack me because I have the...
Maybe one day I'll have a normal life, like...
That voice in the sky, or voice of the sky. Effect from doing the pilgrimage up to High Rothgar.
What was that?
If I hit the bad guy with my weapon, he starts to bleed out, but that's all I can get him to do is just take a knee and bleed out. He heals pretty quick once he gets back up. Stamina, so I can't really use my weapon. So I ended up just not going down that road and avoid the guy entirely.
But again, I do not drink. What about a little snack?
So I brought back the axe, and I see that the dog's here. He'd been missing in action.
Ah, you've got the axe! And my dog! Splendid!
Clumsy, aren't you?
Excellent work! A hero and his faithful companion retrieving the ancient artifact for the prince. It's almost storybook.
Time to leave us.
Ah, but it almost seems a shame to give a weapon like that away, doesn't it? I suppose I could be persuaded to let you keep it. But only if you use the axe to kill Barbas. Simple as that.
It's not a very promising place.
Huh. You're no fun at all. Guess I'll have to make my own fun elsewhere. And with the pup back, I'll be restored to my full power. There's a whole world just waiting for me! I knew I could trust you. Yeah, dog gets master, master gets cosmic axe. Everyone's happy, just get over here, mutt. Don't worry, I'll make sure you see the light.
That's a very good idea.
Now you trust me. Ah, that feels so much better. You forget how nice supreme power feels until you've been stuck in a cave for a few years. Now, as for your wish, an end to the war, was it? I'll make sure this war ends all right. Just as soon as the dragons swarm across Skyrim and wipe out all of you puny... Oh, fine. Have my boon and be done with it. Got more interesting deals to make anyway.
I guess he's a deal maker, so... He can only do things... That he made a deal with. If he says, let's make a deal, this will happen or this will happen, then he has to stick to it after the deal's made. Then he's dormant again until someone else comes, finds him, and wants to make a deal.
It's very cold in here. Thank you very much for your help. Isn't it a bit dangerous for a chatter in this place?
I totally forgot about the amulet thing.
I can help you with that.
So now, when we're sneaking around, the amulet will... It does some effect on her. Makes her super stealthy. Or it makes her absorb life force from people when she sneaks around. Or both. Where are you going? I've told her it's okay to wander around a bit. I guess all the naked people have got her all excited. Naked dead vampires. And other things.
That feels good. My legs and feet hurt.
She found an idol up here? Wow. I don't get to do that unless I install a mod, which I'm not about to.
We should be very careful here. I can help you with that.
So I've been buying some hats from Red Guards. Red Guard merchants.
It's getting dark. Watch your health. And your neck. I can help you with that.
They don't work with the hair I'm using. I was curious if they would work on Embryo. I had to go back to a different hairstyle that would work with the hat. Because the hair disappears when you put a hat on in Skyrim. But if the hair isn't told to do that,
okay,
you have all kinds of weird issues when you put on a hat. Is she coming? I have to do my little duck thing to get her to follow me now. So the hat works with her hair.
Much knowledge lies within the college's walls. No? Well, if you think you're capable of it, then I'd be happy to provide it to you for a mere 30 gold.
Yeah,
so or you can try your luck with one of the court
wizards. I ended up buying the spell from her.
They also sell spells. Here you are. Now I'm anxious to see you cast it.
I went all over. I could not find the fear spell, so went on all kinds of adventures. All kinds of side quests. No fear spell.
Who knows? Maybe one day I'll have a normal
one. So I thought I'd wait for her to witness me doing this.
Well done indeed.
Yep, she saw it.
I think you'll be a superb addition to the college. Welcome, apprentice. I'll lead you across the bridge. Once you're inside, you'll want to speak with Mirabelle Irvine, our master wizard. Please, follow me.
Alduin is a big threat with Skyrim. I hope we can stop him.
Okay, so now we can go into the, we can go into the college Winterhold. Wet and cold screwing her up. Could be wet and cold that's messing her up too. As far as where she's supposed to be standing. Because wet and cold messes up her aiming. She can't aim worth beans. So her little mage-like things are sticking to walls instead of going off to where they're supposed to go. Oh well.
The college is filled with such wonders. But I wish that traveling from floor to floor was a bit more magical. Why have stairs when one can have a jump?
Yep, these two are still staying here, waiting for me to show up.
I believe I've made myself rather clear.
Yes, of course. I'm simply trying to understand the reasoning behind the decision.
You may be used to the Empire bowing to your every whim, but I'm afraid you'll find the Thalmor received no such treatment here. You are a guest of the college, here at the pleasure of the Archmage. I hope you appreciate the opportunity.
Yes, of course. The Archmage has my thanks.
Very good. Then we're done here.